Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and a very good morning to all in this video. So friends, in this video we are going to see about Tata Motors Limited as well as about Tata Motors DVR, and one of those main things that I want to discuss here with you, what is it? Initially when I started coverage a long months back, but frequently when I started coverage around 2 weeks back or 3 weeks back, when the share price was 180 or so, I said 200 rupees could be one of the greater barrier for Tata Motors to cross, and after that we could have a strong run, I think. But seriously saying, I never expected this kind of performance from Tata Motors. What I'm trying to say is that is I thought that okay, the company share price would rise to 300, 400 as the days passing by, but there would be certain dips and certain ups, not a continuous up like this. I mean, that's why I always say, right, we should not underestimate the power of Tata's in the market alone. And currently the market cap is now around 85,000 crore. If this kind of case is going to happen for sure, and the share is going to cross 300 rupees, let us take an example, the company market capital could hit 1 lakh crore of market capital. I think that is one of the factors. I don't know particularly why, but I think Tata Motors is running for that to reach that $1 billion market capitalization. So recently the shareholding pattern has been announced by the company. Yes, there was a good shareholding pattern, but there was a little bit of pledge by the promoters which has been continued, and surprisingly mutual funds have reduced their stake. Now we should think here, once upon a time was a different story. So recently there was an update from a Tesla, okay, or there was an update regarding that Tata Motors and Tesla would be joining hands to produce the Tesla EV in India, I mean electronic vehicles in India. But surprisingly, you see, Tata Motors declined once, not once but twice, saying that no, they are not joining hands with us, we are working on our own, they are working on their own. I think this was the comment basically from them, their side. But even after saying this, right, and even after market hammering the shares for the past 2 days, the kind of volatility and kind of momentum in the share price is going to be very, very important. Because once it's going to cross 300 rupees, it's going to be very, very important, as you say, right. I'm going to say two or three resistance points that you should have in your mind. And the first resistance is 278. I think yesterday's high, 278. And once it is going to cross 278, the next resistance is going to come at 287. And when it is going to in the range of 287, 278 would be base, and it would continue like that, okay. And once you're going to cross 287, there could be a short up move up to 295, 296, and you know what's going to happen. It will not cross 300 in short, it will come down again, come up again, and finally cross 300 rupees. I'm not saying it's going to cross within 2 days or 3 days, it may take weeks or it may take months also, but I'm sure that it is going to cross 300 rupees as the days coming by. And people are closely watching out for the quarter results from this company, because it has been many quarters the company has posted profit. I think the kind of losses this company posted produced, as you can see here, 1000 crores of loss in September quarter, 2000 crores of loss in June quarter, and FY19 the company posted $1 billion of loss. I think I seriously never expect this kind of performance from Tata Motors Limited. And basically being a Tata company, I always expect a decent profit from this company. And if the company can break even in this quarter, I mean the quarter 3, if the company can break even, then it's going to be very, very important. Now let us come to the next factor, Tata Motors DVR. And one more thing friends, the discount value has been increased again. If you compare the discount valuation of Tata Motors DVR versus Tata Motors Limited, I think Tata Motors Limited DVR should rise furthermore up to 114 rupees in order to match the current market price. Now what is the benefit of this is that even if today the Tata Motors is going to come down, Tata Motors DVR will not come down to a greater extent, because they will be equal in matching the so-called valuation concept. Because if you compare the percentage of gains that Tata Motors and Tata Motors DVR are having, I expect a strong re-rating from Tata Motors DVR. So I think already a 100% return the share has given from the range when started. I think mainly I said I'm only focusing on Tata Motors Limited DVR because I thought DVR could provide a further valuation and as well as protect the so-called protection base due to the discount valuation is having in the market. So 48 rupees, I think it has done already the doing what is need to be doing. So 51, I think 51 or 52, we are going to start the coverage. I think it's now around 104. So which means basically it has given 100% return. Now the third concept. What to do now? Can I book my profits or can I hold my shares? Being a Tata company, even if it falls today, it is going to rest over. I think this is even you go ask to anybody in the market, they will say this only. Even if Tata falls, shares fall tomorrow or today, it will going to rise in the future. So if you are going to be an investor, think about the business of the company. The company is changing purely into an electronic vehicle company. And you know what valuation an electronic vehicle company is getting valuation. And remember one thing. I think they are the market leaders in EV in India right now and I hope that they should sustain that position to a greater level so that they could get an enormous valuation. I think those are the times where Tata Motors was trading in the range of around 405 rupees. I mean, it's in the year of 15-16 or 16-17. I think after that the cycle was bad. And recently in November we started our first coverage regarding Wheels India, Tractor India Limited, etc. And Tata Motors also, he said that the cycle is recovering for these EV vehicles also and also for these commercial vehicles and EV vehicles. So this budget is going to be one of the triggers. Now, as an investor, kindly hold your positions, whatever may happen to the share. You know what Tata Group can do. But if you want, as an investor also, you want to earn some profit, try to book 10 to 20% of your holding as a profit. Now, coming as a trader, having 40% means, suppose you are holding 100 shares in Tata Motors Limited or Tata Motors DVR as the case may be. If you are a trader, try to take 40% of it as a trading volume, 60% of it will be an investor volume. So as another share price raises, try to exit 40 shares in the market. I mean 270, 280, 290, 300. I mean try to exit in a partial way so that you could get an incremental profit from it. Okay. And once you have done that, then wait simply in the corner and wait for the company's performance and enjoy it. Okay, this is what a real investor should do, a real trader should do. And let us see what my friends are going to do. Thank you, friends, and bye.